I was just starting a new job and I really wanted to do well at it. It was one of my first jobs after college. But I was having sleep issues, like really bad. Like I wasn't getting a good night's sleep. I was having no trouble falling asleep, but I was just waking up so many times. And I'm not a person who can function on little sleep. I need a full night's sleep. And I knew I couldn't function at this job if I wasn't sleeping. So I did all the things. I went to the sleep study place, one at Chevy Chase, where they hook you up to the contraptions and you know, they measure all the stuff, and I'm waiting with bated breath to get my results. And finally the results come back and they're like, guess what? You're perfectly normal. And I'm like, oh, okay. And then I read the report and it tells me I woke up 18 times that night. And I'm like, that can't be normal, you know? And they're like, well, maybe you should practice sleep hygiene. You know, light some candles. I'm like, candles are not gonna... I'm like, I need drugs for this. So I make an appointment with my doctor and I explain the situation to him and we decide on a very low dosage of Ambien, which I'd never taken before. And he says to me, before he gives me the prescription, he writes it, but then he says... before you take this, I have three rules of Ambien. Okay? First rule, no drinking alcohol either before or after or during taking the Ambien. Okay, easy. Second rule, make sure you get 8 hours of sleep. Like allocate for yourself 8 hours because that's what you need when you're taking Ambien. And okay, that's fine. And third, don't operate heavy machinery. Like, is that really necessary? Fine. Okay, great. So he hands me the prescription and I go fill it out and I'm really excited about this because I haven't had a good night's sleep in as long as I can remember. And so I put it in my bag and this medicine is burning a hole in my bag. And it's a Monday night and I had dinner plans with my friend Rachel that night. And usually Rachel and I linger at dinner because we don't see each other very often. And the waiter kept coming over. He was like, do you want dessert? Do you want coffee? You know? And she's like, oh, I'll take a look at the dessert menu. And I'm like, no, you won't. Because I had to get home, but I didn't want to tell her why, you know, like, yeah, I'm going to get a good night's sleep. Yeah, how bad does that sound, right? So finally, we leave dinner. And I get home and I'm so excited and I plan out the course of my night. Okay, so it was this new job and I was, you know, getting up at 8 a.m. So I figured if I went to bed at 11, if I took the pill at 11, I had an hour buffer. I fall asleep by midnight and I get my 8 hours of sleep. Okay, so I get home and I'm so excited and I put on my pajamas and like not even, like I put on my nice pajamas, you know, like the special ones. And I take the Ambien at 11 and I lay down in bed and I turn off the light and I fall immediately to sleep. I'm like, this is great. And I wake up and I look at my alarm clock. This is before iPhones. And it says 12. And I'm like, great. I didn't sleep at all. I've only slept an hour. Like, I need to call the doctor and complain. It's not working. And then I realize it's not midnight. It's noon the next day. And I'm like, oh my God, I just started this job. They're gonna fire me. I didn't call in. And like, these are the days you don't like text your boss now. You have to call and be like, I'm sick, you know, but I couldn't do that. I was sleeping. So I didn't know what to do. So I kick the covers off of myself and I look down at myself and I'm not wearing my nice pajamas anymore. I'm naked. But I'm not completely naked. I'm wearing a towel and I'm soaking wet. I'm like, what? So I'm trying to retrace. I don't know. Apparently, I had woken up at 8, took a shower, got ready for work, put on my towel, and went back to sleep. And now it's noon. And I'm like, oh my God, they're going to fire me. So I call my boyfriend at the time and I'm like, Brian, you need to drive me to work. And he goes, well, where are you? Home. Well, why? I overslept. He goes, well, why can't you drive yourself? And I go, I can't operate heavy machinery. So he picks me up,
drives me. I throw on whatever I find, you know. He picks me up. He drives me to work. I get to work and I see my boss immediately. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Like, it won't happen again. I promise. And I'm thinking, oh my God, just let me keep this job, right? And he looks at me and he goes, what are you doing here? I'm like, what do you mean? What am I doing here? He goes, well, you called me. What did I say? Because, well, you told me you had a bad reaction to some medication. I'm like, oh, good, that's true. That's true. So he looks me up and down, and I'm usually decently put together. Like, I like clothing. And I'm one of those people who buys multiple, like, colors of things when I like it. And he looks down, and I have a brown and a black shoe on. And he goes, Erica, go home. And I call the boyfriend again because there was no Uber. He was a saint. He picks me up from work. He drives me home. I get home. I put back the nice pajamas. I go back to bed. And that is the first and the last time I have ever taken Ambien. Thank you.